A web application runs on a server. Here we'll use Tomcat, which is Apaches. Go to the Tomcat folder.
If you expand the folder, in that you'll get web apps. So first I'll show you how to do it step by step through command line, then we'll go over to Eclipse, because you need to know how exactly Tomcat works. So go to Tomcat folder and inside the web apps, okay, here create a folder. Create a folder. Fine. And put one index.html there. Edit that. Open with Notepad. Now you are coming to advanced Java, so and you're creating a web application. And so we need to know HTML. Okay. Give some title. Something you can give. It is kept inside the folder inside web apps. So I have given as test. Inside the text as I'm having index.html and I'm having other files because I gave a reference to the zip file. You can do whatever you want. HTML you should know. Fine, write HTML. Go to bin folder. Bin is binary. In that startup.batch file is there. Startup.bat. Execute that, it will start your Tomcat.
Done.
Once this is done, now you can access it through your browser. So web application is running on HTTP, so you can use your browser to access it. Open the browser, http://localhost, and give the IP address and the or local host and the port number. In your case it is 8080.
8085.
No, 8080. Mine is 8085. I changed it. I'll show you how to change it. You'll get the welcome page of Tomcat. Okay, some error is there. Go to logs. It's saying it's already in use.
Go to conf folder and open server.xml and search for the port number.
See how to change the port. In your server.xml, in the conf folder, in the XML, you have connector port equal to 8085. It is 8080. Search for 8080. You can change it to any other port if you want, because your machine may be already using the port. If it's already using the port, you cannot run it again. So you need to change that port so that get freed and you can use it. Be careful, this is a configuration for your engine. So any change you make, it will affect the engine. Let me see with connector port, uncommented. This is for HTTP. Don't touch anything else. Let me just see if it works. Okay, still having error. Looks like 8005. How to find it? So kill it. Okay, solution for that, run this shutdown.batch. If your ports are occupied and it is not because of somewhere else, try somewhere else, try to search for the ports using this and kill these processes, but it didn't work, so I ran this shutdown.batch because the same Tomcat has created the problem. OS is thinking the ports are occupied. Run that, then you run this. So now it's running. Okay, if I change the port, it is 8089. So successful. So if you're seeing this, you successfully installed Tomcat. And you can also click on any of the setup if you want, but not important. Okay, so leave it as it is. Now we'll straight away go to our application which I created. So I created a test folder, just a folder, that is your application, and I'll say /test. That is my project. If I say this, it will open by default index.html. As you see, it's index.html. Save it. So put your HTML here in the index.html. By default, it will search for index. And if you want to link to some other page from here onwards, you can link. Now, for example, I put this href hyperglyph reference with the Java quiz. So you can see here, below you can see here. Localhost 8089 Java quiz 123 zip. So it's linking to that file. You can also link to any HTML page and so on. That left to you. How do you want to write HTML? Okay, so front end you should know a little bit of HTML, CSS, JavaScript, etc. Because your application will have all this. It's good to know jQuery, AngularJS, whether it's advanced versions. At least minimum you should know HTML, little bit of JavaScript. And CSS. So steps are like this: extract your Apache and keep it ready. Run this. If some problem is there with the ports, shutdown.batch is there. Anytime you can run this, it will shut down this automatically. Or you can say Control C. If you want to stop it, Control C, or just run this batch file. is stopping. Okay, they're shutting down. Just close all the ports and everything. Then run again. So it's a clean start. You write the HTML and now main thing. We would like to do something with the backend programming. Who will respond to the requests from the front end? So I will say login, I will say save. So backend there should be a program which will take the request and process it and put it in database or whatever and send the reply back to the front end. So there comes in Java something called servlet. Servlet is the one who receives the request from the front end. So I have written one. Hello servlet. Okay. It is normal Java only. So what I'll do, I'll modify this index.html. Okay, modify the index.html and write here form slash form. So write a form there. Form is a tag in HTML and say action is equal to say hello. Method is equal to get. We will see all this later. Just put it. Then I will say name input type equal to text. Name equal to, in the servlet you have used a name, my name. Copy this. This is how it refers to that. Backend you are going to get this. So whatever name you are given, the backend is going to read it. Okay. So the same name should be used here. Value is equal to, user will give it blank. Close it. Okay. So input is a tag in HTML which takes input from the client. So what is the type? It's a text. That means it's a text field. It is having a name because the backend has to call it by some name. The same name has to come here. Value is blank. The user will give the value. Fine. This is one of the inputs. You can have many, many inputs, but I will just use one. One more input. User is going to click this, so I will say type is equal to submit, value is equal to submit. This is a button. Submit is a button, but it's a special button. It will submit this entire form to the server. It will go and fetch hello. Make sense? So what this submit is going, it's going to be a button. If you refresh and see, you can see that. If you want a break here, put a break. BR. Save it. Refresh. Okay. So button has come below. You can do whatever you want HTML. Okay. So the form is a tag. Entire content is submitted to the server. Because this page itself is in server, it will give a related path, relative path. That means test slash hello. So if I say like this, submit, you can see it. Hello has come here. Fine? It went to the URL. because I gave hello here. It went to the URL. Okay, and it picked up this whatever you have inputs, that my name it picked up and gave the value as whatever the user has entered. Make sense? This is the way it works from front end to back end. But nobody is there in the back end, so it's not, it said nothing is available, the hello is not available. Now, how to make that hello available? Now, go to your Tomcat, go to test. Okay, first shut down your Tomcat because making changes. Shut down. In test, create another folder called web-inf. Create a folder called in caps web-inf. Inside this, I'll create a web.xml. You can copy from somewhere. Maybe from manager you can copy. Yeah, copy from manager. Reduces your job. You need to know XML configuration first. Okay. Edit that web.xml. Remove unnecessary things. Comments this. I'll give just one servlet, remaining all else. So one servlet mapping and one servlet. Is it class name? This is some name. Same name should be here. And here I'll give. This is from front end. So what has happened here? It has sent hello here. So the same hello, I am mapping it in my web.xml as slash hello. What is it referring to? It is referring to some my hello here. It will search for my hello. Is there a servlet? Yes, it is there. What is the class? So I will give the class now. So I will make a class called hello servlet. Okay, so it's having a package com abc training, com abc training dot my hello servlet or hello servlet. Okay, so this is my complete path, this is my class, it's from here, com abc training hello servlet. Okay, so this is my class. And this is internal reference, should be same as this. And this is from client, is coming like this, URL pattern. Because it's coming like that. It came to my server. It asked, somebody is requesting for this in the server. It is mapped in WebXML. And WebXML will search, that the container will search for that. Mm-hmm. Okay. So the steps are like this. Let's do it like this. Okay. In WebINF, I have WebXML, so it is just a static file, right? But it has meaning for your application. When the Tomcat runs, it load this. Any error this in your error. It loaded. Okay. Slowly, I'll explain this later. What is this, all this stuff about? Okay. Just understand this. We need to give a servlet tag. Inside that, servlet name, also servlet class. You have to give a servlet mapping. Inside that, servlet name, and then URL pattern, and then close it. XML, all whatever you open should be closed. Okay, whatever you open, web app, should be closed and nested properly. Display name is closed here. Description is closed here. Servlet is closed here. Servlet mapping is closed here. Right? Everything should be closed properly. Such an XML is called well-formed XML. Well-formed XML. Is it a valid XML? That your container will check. It has a parser. XML parser is there. It will compare with this XSD. Okay? It will compare with the XSD, which is there in your servlet jar. XML namespace is there. It will give exactly like this. XSI. That is XML and XSI because you will be using that. This is XSI. And that XSI schema location. This is again same thing. Java E. And this is XSD. It will compare with this XSD to understand what is this stuff. Otherwise it has no meaning. XML has no meaning unless you compare with XSD. Because it's extensible markup language. No meaning is of all this. Unless you say, what is all this? That is said in the XSD. This compulsory. If this is there, then your container, the Tomcat container, servlet container is there. Servlet container picks up this, loads this XML. If no error is there, it will successfully deploy your project. You must have seen when it's running, deployed so and so, complete the same. Right? It is already having projects. It's already having docs, examples, host manager, manager, root. This is extra which you made. Okay? So you'll follow the same steps what they are given. So inside test you'll have XHTML. In WebINF you'll have WebXML plus. Now where do you put my class? Create one more folder inside this WebINF. In lowercase classes. No mistake spelling. Here you have to put the class. Okay? Because you said, no? You told there is a class. So you need to bring this now. How to bring it? Compile and put it. Go to your folder. You have this now, right? Go to servlets. Open the command line in your servlets folder. So open CMD. Okay. You need to put jar files in path. Okay. Jar files are required because your servlet is using some classes. This is okay, we have it, but we do not have this. These are present in a jar file. So these jar files should be there in your path. Okay, go to the set class path. Set class path. Copy this and paste it. Okay, so this jar file comes in the path. So I put the servlet API jar file. Where did I get this? It is there in your Tomcat. Tomcat is Java specific. If you go to lib, you can see servlet here. You can see it is there. It comes with Tomcat. So I copied and pasted there. Now it is there in my folder. I will use that to compile my servlet because servlet is using those classes. We will see that later. What are these classes? Okay. Java is like that. Just use your existing classes. So I need to compile it. So Java C minus D dot hello Hello server dot java. So compiling it. Okay, I'm compiling this class. It is done. Fine, this got compiled. Copy it. Com is as you can see. Copy the entire folder, com folder, because it is complete path. We need com also, right? So copy that com folder and put it in classes folder. Then now your servlet is also ready. So inside classes you have com dot abc dot training dot class. So now it's happy about the configuration. So you are saying com abc training hello servlet, it is there. So what will happen now? Let us go through this again. If a request comes with hello, your container will search my hello, it is here. It will load this class from the classes folder. This is the program which will start processing the request. Okay, we'll see the internal of that later. Right now we are not Java programming, we are just configuration managers. This is not done by developers, it is done by deployment managers. We are looking at a job of deployment manager now. So that's their job to start the Tomcat, put the classes, put the configuration, everything. Now you saw this, it's ready. Then let us run it. If it doesn't run, it will give error. If anything is wrong with your XML, it will give error. Test is getting error. If error is there, it will come now. If XML error is there, it's unable to load the class. Successful. Right? Finished. No errors. Refresh it. Okay. Now see, it came from the servlet. How it came? Let us see. Now let us see the code. What we have written here. So how it has come? It has come replied from the, see here, it's writing an HTML. See, you see the HTML here? It actually created this. It is actually creating an HTML. Right click and see. Looks same, right? See? Everything whatever written is come here. The sample, servlet example, everything is coming. It has written back to the client. Correct. Close the screen. Right, see? Hello, name. This has come from front end. It picked up the name. Right? So it picked up the name from here. If you look at the name variable, this is a variable. How it came? It came from the request. Get parameter my name. So from the front end it came. You see my name is there. It came from this value. And it came through the URL. If you look at the URL, it has come here. See my name equal to Java. You don't need the text HTML, directly give you. If you give this URL directly, it will directly give you that. But then user doesn't know all this. We know because we are programmers. We can write this, but user can't write it. So provide a UI for the user. Right? That's the reason I provide a UI, which is a HTML. And you don't need that. Actually, you can write directly hello question variable equal to this and ampersand variable equal to value ampersand. You can keep on giving it. Multiple you can give. So whatever you have in the series, all of them with the name value to go with ampersand in the URL. Fine. So if I write like this, one more. If I write like this, see what will happen. Thank you. see that ampersand has come here. That means it will keep on name value, it will put on this after a question mark. This is the URL. And how did it go? It went to the container, and where you have mapped it as hello, it searched for this my hello, it came here, it loaded this class, and this is the class it loaded, and that value went inside. You can get one more, but mobile also you can get. So get parameter, as many as that you can get it, right? Now let us see the servlet. This much is clear? The process is clear, right? We still didn't see the code. So till now we are looking at the deployment steps. This is a Java. You can easily see it is package, some import statements, public class, hello, extends, all this is Java. Now what is this HTTP servlet? This technology has been there for more than 15 years. Servlet technology. For taking a request from the client, you need to have a servlet. Whether Spring, Scratch, whatever architecture, you need to have a servlet in Java, right? So HTTP servlet is HTTP protocol, right? Because the browser uses HTTP protocol. So HTTP servlet in Java, you know, if you do not know how to write the code, extends, simple. The whole thing comes into your class. So my hello servlet is having everything in HTTP servlet. So I don't need to write extra code inside it. So how it receives the request, how it initializes the servlet, everything that they will do, the parent will do. So I don't need to bother. So the servlet container inside this Tomcat has loaded that servlet. So it knows everything because HTTP servlet has been extended. Right, so that is there in the package javax servlet http servlet in that jar file, in this jar file it is there. That is why the lib folder is necessary. Whatever you want, you can put it here, or you can put it in the webinf lib also. Only if you want the jar file to be inside this, make a lib folder here and put the jar files. So that will not go to other projects. Fine. Now HTTP servlet has been extended. So it has a method called doGet. One more is that doPost of interest to us. So what is doGet? Because the front end is saying get. This is HTTP method, not Java. HTTP has certain methods like get, post, put, delete, all this. Of interest to us is to get request and post request. Get request goes through the URL. You can see here, it went through URL. There's a danger here. Your password will be visible to anybody who accepts your request. Not a good idea. So get request is very fast. Why? It goes through the URL. Right. But post request does not go through URL, it goes through the body only. Right? So nobody can hack into it. So if there is a password in your form, be careful. Don't send a get request. Do it as a post request. In that case, you will be writing do post. Okay? So you need to decide whatever the front end is saying, same thing back end also should say. So it is do get. Process get request in the clients. Fine. Now the do get method has two parameters. One is HTTP servlet request and the other is HTTP servlet response, standard. So I give it a name, req and res, whatever. Okay, two parameters are there. This is also HTTP protocol based, right? The request object comes from the client having the form inside that. The entire form is coming through this request. The technology has ensured that this whole stuff is packed into this request and is coming here. You can access it. See, I have accessed it. It's successful, right? So I'm accessing it from the backend. So all this name, whatever is there, I can use it. Okay. So how to send it back now? I will send it back through the response object. Request, I got it now. I know the funder now. Form has come in through the request object. Now how to send it back? The response object is responsible for sending it back. So how to write into that? It's a stream now. So I have to get the writer. So I will get a writer out of it. Print writer we call it. Now I need to tell the browser what is coming to you. So I will tell it is text by HTML. Set content type. Okay. The response content type is set as text by HTML. It's a MIME. Multi-purpose internet mail extension. So there are many. HTML is one of them. MIME it is. Multi-purpose internet mail extension. I need to tell the browser what you are receiving is HTML. Else it will print as it is. It will not interpret those tags. Right. So I need to tell this HTML. So it will interpret as a HTML. It can be JPG, GIF, MPG, whatever you want. Right. So many MIME types are there. Then I'll get the writer out of it, and into that writer I'll start writing it. Println, printf, println. I'll keep on printing the text, and this is going to be your HTML. So write the entire thing. Just copy paste and put that out.println. Okay. So this is going to be my HTML, which the response will convey. After writing all the streams, say close. Last is HTML and then close. End the existing document, finish. That's all. It's as easy as. This is the steps which I explained to you. Read through this, you'll understand. A lot of stuff is in this. See, get, head, post, delete, put, trace. You don't worry too much about it. Just look at post and get. Okay. Then what is URI, etc. Headers are there. A lot of information goes. So this is the way it is. So this is what has happened. And you see what happened now. Whatever came from printf, it came here. Hello, name, blah blah. Only thing is that if you modify this HTML servlet, you have to recompile it again. Recompile it again and put it back again. Restart your Tomcat. Now the servlet remains in memory for around half an hour. So if you put that class again, no use. After half an hour you have to put or restart your engine. Either restart the Tomcat or wait for some time. After 1 hour you come back, they remove the servlet to save memory. And it is multi-threaded by default. This technology is very robust, it will never fail. And 24/7 any time it will work. You don't have to shut down this server any time. Because normally we don't shut down. Clients will be affected. So many people are accessing it, right? In real life. So normally we don't shut down unless you give warning to them. 1 week in advance, I'll tell. We are going to shut down for so and so time, so and so date. Fine.